Welcome back to the garage. Today, instead of addressing some of the more glaring issues with the Jeep, such as that, hey, as long as it's leaking oil, I know it's still got oil, right? Yeah. But instead of fixing that, I'm going to continue on the little side trip I'm doing towards accessorizing the Jeep. Today I thought I would look at what it would take to remove and refurb these two little rear seat bracket clamps. This one seems a little bit worse for wear. Both of them seem to have problems with the springs. They might need to be replaced, but I want to at least give it a shot. So let's see what it'll take to knock these loose and see if we can get them out of here.
Let's see how it looks from below. This does not spark joy.
Well, I can't tell if it's just rusted solid or if the spring steel that's in here on either side has rusted away, and that's why these have moved back and are now kind of stuck in place. But let's get the other one out of there and tear these down and clean them up, and let's find out. This passenger side one has some weird damage on it. Not sure how that happened, but it's in a similar condition as the driver's side one. See if I can hammer that down once I get these apart. Been a minute since I could see the workbench surface. Let's see what I've got that might take this apart. Let's see what's hiding inside, if anything. Ah, there's still spring left. What do you know? Not so much on this side. It's interesting because it returned to its shape as soon as I started scraping stuff off of it. Might be able to just reuse the original springs. I'm honestly pretty shocked that there's still spring steel in here. I guess there was a rear seat on this Jeep at some point, and it was left in for so long that it basically rusted the springs to the edges. Looks like it's in the same boat. There's one spring, and there's the other, exactly like the other was. Rusted at the back. Springs right back. So I guess the last remaining question is the
repair worthiness of these steel rods. There doesn't seem to be much left of them. Fortunately, that's just a hardware store item. That might just work again. Yeah, let's blast these and get them painted. Cleaned up all right. I went ahead and took these over to the wire wheel, and yeah, they're pretty well pitted on one side. The right thing to do would be to take that to the hardware store and get the correct replacement rod for it. But I think I'll probably just blue these or something so they don't rust up again, and just run them and see how they work. But these are gonna need paint. Better than it was. Driver side pins were even better. It's not a dang thing wrong with this one. This one, not so much. But the springs, I mean, this one here, 70 something years old, that looks brand new almost. The other one, not so much. But I think these are completely usable. Now that this is all sat overnight, that looks pretty good for what it is. So let's do the reassembly now. And there you have it. Two of the rear seat retaining clips restored to functionality, not a perfect restoration, but they do appear to function as intended. Now let's run over to the Jeep and reinstall them. All right. Wish I knew what happened to the loom on this side, but here we go. Two for two. Too shiny for this paint. Whew, that was a lot of work for some things that you can't really see. But there was a reason for that. And that's over here. Yep, I finally bit the bullet and got a back seat. And I did this under the guise of cleaning out the trailer. Longtime viewers will remember that I picked up these seat covers off eBay really early on in the project. And I got these and I didn't even have a rear seat. I didn't know if I'd ever have one. So they've been stored in the Bantam for quite a while now. So I told myself, well, all I'm doing is I'm finally cleaning out the Bantam trailer. And that's why this makes sense now. So yeah, that makes sense, right? So I have a few more holes to drill to screw this thing down, but then we can actually go put the rear seat in the Jeep and make sure it'll latch. And I think it will. That took a long time to drill with the dullest drill bits in the state, but it's done. I'm still not 100% sure if these are supposed to go on the outside or the inside, because I've seen pictures both ways, but I think the cushion will stay in place. So let's get this thing installed. Now, I've never actually had a CJ2A with functioning rear seat retainer clips. But theoretically, this should just kind of click into place. Well, there we go. That seems like it'll do. And there we have it. Between the summer top and the rear seat, it just looks that much more complete, doesn't it? And now I can actually take more than one passenger with me, as long as the other brave passenger has really short legs. I also added a couple of these straps here so the brave passenger can hang on for dear life. So thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please leave me a like and a comment. If you're new here, maybe subscribe. Perhaps you'll find something interesting along the way. So thanks again, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.